Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the Golden Opportunities Coaching and Pro Wrestling Logic YouTube channels. Welcome to those of you who are new. Welcome back to those of you seasoned veterans of what we do around here. What we do around here is bring about conversations of a psychological, mental health, emotional health paradigm. We do that as often as we can. We do that for your listening pleasure and for a variety of reasons. This is the Superstars of Wrestling Review Series for August 20th, 1994. Not exactly the best time to be a fan, but also by far not the worst. Anyway, this particular run of programs will stop with the, I believe, September 3rd edition, so we've only got a few more of these. We are starting the Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling Review Series as well, probably some within the next couple of days. Anyway, so we have Diesel against Kevin Kruger. Diesel's still the Intercontinental Champion for another couple weeks until he goes into the loss at SummerSlam. Of course, we don't know that when this show takes place, but Diesel comes down and again, seconded by Shawn Michaels. Of course, Razor Ramon defeating him at the SummerSlam in a couple of weeks here. Punch kick, very basic stuff by Diesel. Diesel hits the sidewalk slam and the powerbomb, the jackknife powerbomb, and the win, the big boot as well. Special interview with Owen Hart, the King of Hearts, basically saying that this feud has been coming to a close for a long time. He will defeat Bret Hart inside the steel cage. Vince McMahon impressing the danger of the cage. Only two ways to win. One, you climb over the top of the cage. Two, you have to manage to get things going on the other end of the pathway. And again, it's not exactly the best of situations. The Bret Hart Owen Hart feud ending isn't necessarily the best thing for business, although it had been going on for more than a year at the time, over a year at the time. So, I mean, they got a lot of mileage out of it, and they still do wrestle into 1995, so it's not over all the way, but this, the cage match is the biggest singles match they have on television. They still do go into 1995, doing battle with each other upon occasion. More occasions than a lot of people would realize, actually. Anyway, we see Bob Sparkplug Holly in a match here. Sparky Plug defeating George Anderson. Plug basic maneuvers, drop kick, and the top rope run here. Sparky Plug at the time. He used a bit, not exactly the greatest of situations. He's still doing the two-sport thing. Razor Ramon saying he's going to defeat Diesel for the Intercontinental Championship. At SummerSlam, Walter Payton will be in his corner, and that is to be expected. Highlights of the Atom Bomb match from the previous weekend, taking out Adam, well done pretty aggressively here. Also some highlights of some upcoming matches in the area of kind of local area house shows and the like. Simple stuff, nothing necessarily that needs a great deal of attachment there, but Doink the Clown pinning Ted Miller with the whoopee cushion, basic stuff there, and Doink punch kick, arm drag, basic stuff, and ultimately getting the whoopee cushion from the top rope. That is Phil Apollo in that particular role at that particular time. We continue to go through the process here, and also Atom Bomb kind of, you know, they re-show the well-done match, kind of not exactly a gracious thing here. Also, a Smoking Guns and Timothy Wells, Stephen Dunn, and Quang versus Smoking Guns and Atom Bomb. Kind of a six-man tag team match here. Quang goes with Harvey Whippleman, as does the wonder that is the masked individual in Quang. So, I mean, some body slams, basic stuff there. Timothy Wells, Stephen Dunn gets things going that way, and punch under the chin by Quang. Quang managing to get a cross body. Billy Gunn manages to do that, and Quang comes up a bit. They cut the ring off. Hot tag down and bomb, power used by bomb, uses the pump handle slam, and the baby faces get the win in pretty quick order. Continuation of the goofiness with Leslie Nielsen. He never does Find the Undertaker. I know people think this is funny, but I just never got it at the time. Then we go to a Bam Bam Bigelow match, continuance of the wonder that is the team of IRS and Bam Bam Bigelow facing the Head Shrinkers for the tag team championships at SummerSlam, although the team of Razor and Diesel beat that run there. Bam Bam Bigelow, IRS against Tom Stone and Sonny Rogers. One-sided match, and the body slams and basic more power moves by Bigelow, followed by the running clothesline by IRS gets the win for the Million Dollar Corporation tandem. Match is pretty short. Paul Bearer promises that the real Undertaker will be there at SummerSlam. Also, they are getting ready for the first major event in the United Center. Such a major, important building. Bret Hart promises in the SummerSlam report that there will be no more need for the continuation of the feud between himself and his brother. Razor Ramon promises to beat Diesel for the Intercontinental title, and Lex Luger says that he did not sell out to the Million Dollar Man, and that will be proven in the new run. Lunder Blaze cuts a nonsensical promo, and Luna Vachon screams on behalf of Bull Nakano about the upcoming ladies' championship match, as it were. Then we see a hype match for Typhoon to come forward. Todd Becker facing off against Tatanka. Tatanka managing some arm drags, arm bars, and the like. Samoan drop win, and Luna Vachon catapults women's championship Blaze versus Bull for the following week, and Dumpster versus Double J at the Sunday Night Slam event. And we close on that note. We'll be back with more right after this.